It's my feel good breakfast show. Call us on your cell phone. Culinary hotline bling. That can only mean one thing.
Your feel good breakfast show coming to you live right now on SABC3. And look at those waves. The Cape of Storms really honoring its name today. But we're nice and cozy indoors because it's time for the Culinary Hotline Bling! Ting, ting, ting! You can give us a call on 083-9133. Oh, that's the other number that doesn't work anymore. It's 021-430-9881. We've got a new number. Give us a call on that one. Peter Ayub and Angie Boyd, thank you so much for joining us today because today is a very special day. It's World Chocolate Ice Cream Day.
Sure.
And what could be better on a day like this?
Absolutely. There's a day for everything, isn't
there? Well, probably soup, because it's cold out there. Yes. But we'll make this anyway, because it's nice and delicious. And is there a secret to making ice cream at home perfectly so it doesn't go rock hard?
Yeah. So proper ice cream, classic ice cream, is made with custard and cream and then churned in an ice cream machine.
Yes.
But most people don't have an ice cream machine, myself included. Mm-hmm. So we have a quick and easy method for making ice cream.
All right.
Which is, to take either whipped cream or double cream, and then you add some condensed milk to that.
Just like that?
Just like that.
Whipped cream or double cream plus condensed milk equals ice cream.
Equals ice cream. So what's happening here is that the whipped cream or the double cream, you've aerated it, because normally what an ice cream machine does is aerate the mixture as it freezes it. So here you've already got an aerated mixture.
Uh-huh.
And then the important thing to remember is that your condensed milk is very sweet and sugar doesn't freeze. So you've got a balance between something that does freeze and something that doesn't freeze.
So it should give you that nice in-between.
Yeah. In-between texture.
Okay. Is that then also how you prevent it from crystallizing?
Absolutely. Yeah. And because the excess sugar in the condensed milk, that's sort of when it goes into the freezer, those crystals don't actually happen.
They don't occur.
Okay.
And we've aerated it up front as well.
And when it comes to flavoring it, would you add something like...
You can add anything you like, which is the best part. So
coffee,
you could add coffee, you could add chocolate, you could add lemon zest, you could add fruits and nuts and whatever. So then this is a base, and then you add whatever flavor you want. Yeah.
Beautiful stuff. All right, so like I said, our lines are open and you can give us a call on 021-430-9881 for the Culinary Hotline Bling. Ting, ting, ting. Let's take this one question from Denise Kamara on Facebook. It says, when I'm making baklava, does it make a difference if you pour hot syrup over hot baklava? Or should it be hot syrup over cold baklava? Or vice versa.
Okay.
This is very, very confusing.
The very confusing thing about baklava is where it actually comes from, because every country in the Med claim that it belongs to them. When I make it, I prefer the come straight out the oven, and then my sugar syrup is at, I'd say, about 40, 50 degrees. So it's cooled down, but it's not cold.
Okay.
And then with that, you pour it all over, brush it, make sure it's gone into everything, and then you can back it back into the oven for a little bit, just to crisp it up again.
Does that make sure that it has a kind of layer of...
You want the syrup to soak in, but if it's too hot, it's almost going to be too liquid and make the baklava soggy.
Okay.
So we don't want soggy, we want...
We don't like soggy
syrupy
bottoms.
Yeah.
We don't.
All right? Not in our baklavas, not in our cakes,
not in
nothing.
Anything.
All right. Okay, we'll be right back again. Our number once again is 021-430-9881. We'll be back again with the Culinary Hotline Bling. Ting, ting, ting. It's my feel-good breakfast. Ach, dankie Annel, en ons is nou weer terug in die kombuis vir die Culinary Hotline Bling. Ting, ting, ting. So sê mense in Afrikaans. 021-430-9881. We got a caller on the line all the way from Witbank. Good morning.
Good morning, Sir Jessel. I love you.
No, I love you. I love you. Thank you so, so much. What is your culinary conundrum this morning?
My culinary conundrum this morning is... Ice cream is divine, but I'm a diabetic. Is there any way any flavor I can add to the ice cream that's not going to be so sweet?
All right, let's see what our double panel has to say.
It's a tricky one. I think with diabetics, the best thing is just to have a teeny tiny little bit of what you like, rather than to have a big amount of something that's not good for you. So what I would suggest is actually just to make a frozen lolly. So take some fruit juice and rather do the frozen lolly, because if you take the sugar out of the ice cream, it's going to freeze solid.
So what works really well as well is frozen yogurt.
And I was about to say that. How about that?
Yeah, although it does still have sugar, so we have to be careful about that.
But not as...
Yeah, so wait, with the frozen lolly, could you perhaps add the cream, not the condensed milk, and then you get like
a milky kind of flavoured...
Yeah, so that might work. Try it out at home, and then let us know how that turns out. But as Angie said, it's about watching the complete diet and making sure that you're getting all those good things in. So once again, 0214309881, that's the number to call. Tristan says, is it necessary to add eggs to your mixture when you're making scones or scones?
Scones.
What do eggs do in a cake, muffin, or scone mixture? What do they do?
Okay, well, eggs have a variety of functions. So they lighten the mixture up, they bind the mixture, they enrich a mixture. So they are a necessary part of a cake. And what you'll find is if you leave the eggs out, the mixture either doesn't hold together or it's terribly stodgy. Mm-hmm. And a scone is a very simple cake, and I would just rather put the egg in. It has very little egg in it, but it is necessary to give you that lovely light crumbly texture. Otherwise, you're going to end up either with a biscuit or a bread.
The same as a pasta. I mean, if you
omit the eggs, you're going to have you don't have the same texture.
All right.
If, however, there is an egg allergy and you can't have eggs, the other thing to do is to take 1 tablespoon of soy flour per egg as a replacer.
Okay, all right, soy flour as a replacement. Daniela then asked, in baking, can you substitute canola oil for olive oil if the recipe asks for canola oil?
I actually would prefer using canola oil to olive oil.
Peter's so touched right now, like, how dare you?
It is, what's good about the canola oil, it doesn't add flavors to whatever you're doing, so you're gonna keep it very neutral. Olive oils are too heavy for like desserts and things.
For baking,
absolutely. Mm. So I would rather, even if you have a beautiful bread, you've baked it completely. As you're serving it, drizzle some good olive oil over it. So that way, it's going to be a lot better than actually just losing the taste.
Does the flavor of olive oil intensify if you do bake it?
No. It kills us.
It's got a very intense flavor to begin with. So you need to, if you're baking something, it's got to marry with the olive oil flavors. Otherwise, the olive oil is just going to overpower everything else.
All right. Yeah. So olive oil as a substitute for canola oil? No. Just do what the recipe asks. Please. Thank you. All right. Listen, we're going to keep that line open. 0214309881. We'll be back again with the culinary hotline bling. Ting, ting, ting.
Call us on your cell phone.
Culinary hotline bling.
That can only mean one thing.
Get in there, Peter. Yes, it's that time again for the culinary hotline bling. Ting, 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 baby. Give us a call on 0214309881. We're taking all of your culinary conundrums. Like Mariam, I'm sorry if I'm saying Mariam, says, good morning. How do you omit the eggy smell from royal icing? And how long do you beat those egg whites before you add them into the icing sugar?
Royal icing shouldn't have an eggy smell, so perhaps check the freshness of the eggs first.
Yes, that's
very important. They must be fresh eggs because there's no cooking, and royal icing is just egg white and icing sugar. That's it.
Okay.
You don't beat the egg white at all. In fact, what you do, the classic way to make it is to take a butter knife, and it sounds weird.
Yeah.
And you just add your very well sifted icing sugar into your egg white as you're stirring it.
With
and
a
it
butter
takes
knife.
An awfully long time, but it should. There shouldn't be any air in your royal icing at all.
It better be good and worth it. All right. Geraldine says here, how do I get my cookies hard? Every time I bake, it comes out soft, and I don't know how to get it crispy.
You're the cookie lady.
I'm the cookie lady. either bake them, look, biscuits need to be baked low and slow.
Yes.
So your oven must be at around about 150, 160. Mm. So just leave them in a little longer.
Okay.
They actually will feel slightly soft when they are done. As long as they can be removed from the tray easily, then they're done. The other thing is to check your recipe. You need to have enough fat and enough sugar.
Mm.
Otherwise, it's not going
but
to
sometimes, like your homemade cookies are obviously a lot more enriched because you've made it yourself and you haven't got any stabilizer and things like that.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So, making it on your own is going to be very different.
Don't compare your cookies to other people's cookies because you know it didn't make them the same. But here's a good one. I love this from Precious Sidibe. Precious says, we grew up calling every cooking oil fish oil, okay? So I want to know, is there really even a fish oil? Because I've never seen it on any label. That is a brilliant question.
That's adorable.
Mom would be like, Katla, someone have a fish oil. I'm like, what is it?
It's so true.
Fish oil, there's... It's canola or sunflower. So it's not, we just call it fish oil because it was hot enough to bring those temperatures that you could actually fry your fish or whatever. So that's why it was called fish sauce.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. So what that canola does, it brings itself up to nearly 200 degrees before it burns, so you can actually deep fry stuff as opposed to. That's why you don't use olive oil in those circumstances. Yeah.
But could you actually find fish extract oil and cook in it? Would that be okay?
No. I mean, a fish extract is going to be more of a...
It's a vitamin supplement.
Yeah. I was about to take all those little capsules and break them up into your pan, try and make your scrambled eggs in that this morning and tell us how they taste. How about that? Okay. Deirdre, last question says, I recently found liquid smoke at the local grocery store. What? What's the best used for this beautiful ingredient? Liquid smoke? It's sold?
Yeah, it is. I would say leave it in the shopping center.
Yes, thank you. It sounds like a hoax.
I mean, it is, and it's got, you can imagine what's in it to actually make something. Just smoke it at home. It's so easy. It's so simple. If you want, what I'll do is send a recipe across to Espresso on their website and absolutely. Just go mad. Do your own stuff.
All right, listen, and before we go, we had a caller, I believe, Brian from Cape Town, who says, Peter, you are his favorite chef. He's a high scholar. He's a high scholar who I'm assuming has ambitions of being a chef one day. Peter.
What school's he at?
What school? We don't know. We'll track him down. Yeah.
Track him down.
But yeah, if you listen, Brian, do not buy liquid smoke. Okay? Do the smoking yourself at home with wood and stuff
absolutely.
Like that.
Absolutely. It's so easy.
All right. You guys have been absolutely fantastic. Thank you so much. Thank you for the calls and the interesting questions. Please do keep them coming. If you have any culinary conundrums you'd like to ask us, Facebook, on Twitter, and call us next week again for the Culinary Hotline Bling. Ting, ting, ting!